In this video, we're going to talk about the gas laws. Recall that a law is something that explains what happens, where a theory is something that explains why. So we're going to look at the gas laws. Now, scientists have been studying gases for hundreds of years because they are actually very easy to study in the laboratory with a little bit of equipment that will contain them and equipment that will measure the pressures and the temperatures and the volumes, etc. And their behavior is such that we can form some very predictable formulas based on their behavior. The gas laws involve the four variables that we use in measuring gases. They are the pressure of the gas, the volume of the gas, the temperature of the gas, and the number of moles. Now, the number of moles of gas particles, this is something that we've worked with before. We've worked with moles. But when we deal with gases, we usually use a lowercase n to stand for the number of moles. Like P is the variable for pressure, a lowercase n stands for the variable for number of moles. The units, we already talked a little bit about units of pressure, it's atmospheres, or TOR, or PSI, volume units, milliliters, liters, gallons, whatever unit you want, temperature, degree Celsius is of course the temperature scale that we usually use in the lab. We also use the Kelvin temperature scale, and we're going to see that we need to use the Kelvin temperature scale when dealing with gases. And then the unit for the number of moles is moles. All right, so again, scientists have been studying this for hundreds of years. So we're going to go through the basic laws that describe the gas's behavior as with respect to these variables. And the first law we're going to look at is called Boyle's Law. There was a man named Boyle, and he was studying pressure-volume relationships of gases. He was looking at how the pressure changed when he changed the volume, or vice versa. Now, as he was studying pressure and volume, he was keeping temperature and number of moles constant. In other words, what he was doing is he was looking at just the relationship between pressure and volume. Temperature and number of moles did not give rise to any changes because he didn't change the temperature or the number of moles for each experiment. So he was just looking at the pressure-volume relationships. And what Boyle discovered is that pressure and volume are inversely related. An inverse relationship means that as one of the variables gets larger, the other gets smaller, and vice versa. This might make sense to you if you think about the kinetic molecular theory. If I have a box that has gas particles in it, and they're all moving around and moving rapidly, and now all of a sudden I make that box smaller, I have the same number of particles because I'm keeping the n, the number of moles, constant. I have it at the same temperature, but now they're moving around in a smaller volume, so they're going to bang into the walls more frequently. And as we talked about when we talked about the kinetic molecular theory, the pressure comes from these particles banging into the walls. So as I decrease the volume, as the volume gets smaller, the pressure gets higher. So that's what Boyle's Law told us. Again, he's describing what happens to a sample of gas. And this is exactly what happens. When you change the pressure, the volume changes inversely. And we can get a nice straight line looking at the relationship between pressure and volume, because P is proportional, that's my proportional sign, proportional to 1 divided by the volume. All right, next we're going to look at what's called Charles' Law. There was a man named Charles, that was his last name, and he was looking at the relationship between temperature and volume. And again, he was only looking at temperature and volume. He was keeping the pressure and the number of moles constant. And as he varied temperature and pressure, what he discovered is that the volume and the temperature, he's looking at the temperature and the volume. And as he varied the temperature and volume, what he discovered is that the temperature is directly proportional to the volume, or the volume is directly proportional to the temperature, as long as you are in the Kelvin temperature scale. These are directly related, directly proportional in the temperature scale of Kelvin. And in fact, this is exactly how the Kelvin temperature scale came to be. Let me drag in a little graph. If we look at a graph of volume versus temperature, this is an experiment similar to what Charles did. What he did is he studied at constant pressure and number of moles various gases, and he looked at a plot of pressure versus temperature for each of these gases. And so he couldn't go very low, because if you lower the temperature enough, most gases condense and become liquids, and then if you lower it even more, it becomes solids. But he was looking at particular gases, and he was taking data points on temperature versus volume, and he found, for example, this particular gas. These are my data points. Let's see if I can draw a straight line. So this would be a straight line for these data points. And then he looked at a different gas, and for that different gas, again, he looked at temperature and volume of that second gas, which is going to give different points than the first gas he looked at. And then if we draw a straight line for that second gas, what we find is that for that second gas, those data also give a straight line, and it ends up that they both will intersect the axis at zero volume. When the volume equals zero, the temperature at that intersection for every single gas he tried, just about, the intersection was at negative 273 degrees Celsius. And that, he theorized then, must be the absolute coldest temperature, because you can't have anything smaller than zero volume. Having a negative volume wouldn't make any sense. And so this was sort of the birth of the absolute temperature scale. And the Kelvin temperature scale was devised such that zero was where the volume of a gas would be zero, or the zero in Kelvin was where the volume would be zero, and therefore temperature and volume are directly proportional. That means they go through the zero, zero line. All right. Next law that we look at, we're going to look at Gay-Lussac's law. There was a man. Let me spell his name right. And what he was looking at in relationship to the gases is he was looking at the pressure and the temperature, and how the pressure and temperature changed. And again, remember, there are four variables. The third one is volume. The fourth one is the number of moles. And so what he was doing is he was keeping the volume and the number of moles constant, and just varying the pressure and temperature to see what the pressure and temperature did. And what he discovered is that the pressure is proportional to the temperature. These are directly related. The pressure and the temperature are directly related. And then there's one more that we want to look at, and that is Avogadro's law. You may recall this guy. Avogadro was most infamous, I guess, for looking at Avogadro's number, which is 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd. That's the number of items in a mole. So Avogadro helped define what a mole was. And so you might correctly guess that Avogadro was looking at something about the moles of gas. And indeed, he was. He was looking at the volume and number of moles. And again, there are four variables. So he was holding the pressure and the temperature constant as he investigated the volume and the number of moles. And what Avogadro discovered through his experimentation is that volume is proportional to the number of moles. So as we look at these four laws, we have pressure is inversely proportional to volume, temperature is proportional to volume, directly proportional, pressure is proportional to temperature, and volume is proportional to the number of moles. We can put these all together and say that PV is proportional to NT. And what this does is this combines all four of these relationships. Our volume is proportional to the number of moles, as seen here. Our pressure is proportional to our temperature, as seen here. If we come back over here to the left, the temperature is proportional to the, oops, I'm not far enough. The temperature is proportional to the volume in Charles' law. And there it is. There's my temperature and volume, which are proportional. And then the last thing, one, is that pressure is proportional to 1 over the volume. This one is mathematically a little bit more challenging. That means pressure times volume is proportional to some constant, or proportional to 1, if you will. And so pressure and volume are proportional to some other numerical value. So pressure times volume are proportional to the number of moles and the temperature. And all of these were discovered looking at what happens as we change one of the variables and seeing the influence on the other. Now, so from this, we can actually derive what's called the combined gas law. Sometimes, some people call it the combined gas law. And it looks at how these four variables change with respect to each other. And we usually write it as PV over NT. Notice I just divided by the N and the T. This would be proportional to some constant, regardless of what the conditions were on PV and NT. So if I have condition set 1 and condition set 2, then P1 V1 over N1 T1 will equal P2 V2 over N2 T2. Where the subscripts represent the different conditions of the pressure, volume, moles, and temperature. And now I have a mathematical way of calculating how one unknown variable would behave if I know all the other variables.